Hello and welcome guys to a new video of EduCeption where we are going to solve the ICSE 2019 mathematics question paper. If you like our video, do hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to our channel EduCeption and share this video with all your friends. Without further ado, let's begin with the solutions. We begin with section A, 40 marks. You have to attempt all the questions from this section. Question 1A. Solve the following inequation and write down the solution set. You have the inequation given. You have to represent the solution on a real number line. Let's do this. So this is the given inequation. 11x minus 4 is less than 15x plus 4 is less than equal to 13x plus 14. X belongs to whole number. Now when you solve an inequation, what you should do? Just cover one part up. You get one equation and then cover this part up and you get another equation. Solve both of them and you will get the values. Let's do them. 11x minus 4 is less than 15x plus 4. So 11x will go over there and 4 will come over here. What do we get? Minus 4 minus 4 is less than 15x minus 11x. Therefore, minus 8 is less than 4x. Therefore, minus 2 is less than x. We get the first one. Solving the second one, 15x plus 4 is less than equal to 13x plus 14. So 13x will come over here and 4 will go over there. What we will get? 15x minus 13x is less than equal to 14 minus 4. Therefore 2x is less than equal to 10. Therefore x is less than equal to 5. So what do we get? Minus 2. X is greater than minus 2 and less than equal to plus 5, where x belongs to w, whole number. Let's write the solution set. Now, as x belongs to whole number, x will start from 0. So the solution set will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the number line for whole numbers will be of this sort: 0, minus 1, minus 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You have to make big circles on 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. This is your answer. Moving on to B. A man invests ₹4,500 in shares of a company which is paying 7.5% dividend. If 100 rupees shares are available at a discount of 10%, you have to find number one, number of shares he purchased, and number two, his annual income. Let's do this. All this was given in the question. Total investment is ₹4,500. Dividend percent is 7.5%. The face value is ₹100 and the shares are available at a discount of 10%. So let's calculate the market value first. Now market value will be equal to face value, which is 100, minus 10% of the face value. So what do we get? We get 100 minus 10, which is equal to rupees 90. So the market value is rupees 90. So the number of shares will be his total investment, which is 4500 divided by 90, the market value, which is equal to 50. Okay, this is your first answer. The second one was asked his annual income, that means his dividend. So annual income, dividend will be equal to number of shares into the face value into the dividend percent divided by 100, which is 50 that we calculated. The face value was given 100. The dividend percent was given 7.5 divided by 100. So this gets cancelled out and we will get rupees 375. Your second answer. Moving on to C, we have, in a class of 40 students, marks obtained by the students in a class test out of 10 are given below. You have the given data. You have to calculate the following for the given distribution, the median and the mode. Let's do it. So we have written the given data. Let's calculate the cumulative frequency. 1, 1 plus 2, that's 3, 3 plus 3, that's 6, 6 plus 3, that's 9, 9 plus 6, that is 15, 15 plus 10, that's 25, 25 plus 5, that's 30, 30 plus 4, that's 34, 37 and 40. Over here, 40 is equal to n. Now, let's calculate the median. Now, as n is a even number, we have to use this formula. N by 2 term plus n by 2 plus 1th term divided by 2. So what do we get? 40 by 2 plus 40 by 2 plus 1th term divided by 2. So we will get 20th term plus the 21st term divided by 2. Let's go back to the table now. We can see over here that 20th term and 21st term comes between 15 and 25. So what do we get? We get 6 over here. So let's come down again. So the 20th term is also 6, 21st is also 6 divided by 2. So the median is equal to 6. In number 2, we have to calculate the mode. The mode will also be equal to 6 because it has the highest number of frequencies, which is 10. Moving on to question number 2a. Using the factor theorem, you have to show that x minus 2 is a factor of x cube plus x square minus 4x minus 4. You have to hence factorize the polynomial completely. It's a very easy question. Let's do it. We have the given polynomial fx and gx is equal to x minus 2 is a factor. We have to prove this. So x minus 2 is equal to 0. Therefore x is equal to 2. We'll put the value of x in this polynomial and see whether 2 comes or not. F2 is equal to 2 cube plus 2 squared minus 4 into 2 minus 4, which is 8 plus 4 minus 8 minus 4, and this is 0. Hence x minus 2 is a factor. Now we have to factorize the polynomial completely. So let's divide it. X minus 2, x cube plus x square minus 4x minus 4, x square, so x cube minus 2x square minus plus 3x square minus 4x, so plus 3x, so 3x square minus 6x minus plus, so we get 2x minus 4 in the end, so plus 2 over here, 2x minus 4 minus plus, everything gets cancelled out. So we get the final product as x minus 2 into x square plus 3x plus 2. So let's factorize it now by middle term factor. X minus 2, x square plus 2x plus x plus 2, x minus 2, x plus 2 plus 1, x plus 2, x minus 2, x plus 1 and x plus 2. This is completely factorized. Moving on to 2, part B, you have to prove that cosec theta minus sine theta into sec theta minus cos theta into tan theta plus cos theta is equal to 1. Let's do this. So this was the given question. Let's start with LHS, left hand side. We have all this over here. Let's change everything into sine theta and cos theta. Cosec theta is 1 by sine theta minus sine theta into sec theta is 1 by cos theta minus cos theta, tan theta is sine theta by cos theta, and cot theta is cos theta divided by sine theta. Okay, let's take LCM everywhere. We'll get 1 minus sine square theta divided by sine theta into 1 minus cos square theta divided by cos theta into sine square theta plus cos square theta divided by cos theta into sin theta. We all know the value of this. 1 minus sin square theta, it is cos square theta. 1 minus cos square theta is sin square theta, and sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Let's put all of that. So what do we get? Cos square theta into sin square theta into 1 divided by sin square theta into cos square theta. This and this will get cancelled out, this and this will get cancelled out. So we get 1, which is your right hand side. Hence proved. Moving on to 2, part C. In an arithmetic progression AP, the 4th and 6th terms are 8 and 14 respectively. You have to find the first term, the common difference and the sum of the first 20 terms. Let's do this. So here we are with the solution. The 4th term was given 8 and the 6th term was given 14. We all know the formula of nth term, which is a plus n minus 1 d. We'll use the formula to find two equations for the fourth term and the sixth term. So for the fourth term, 8 is equal to a plus 4 minus 1 into d. Therefore 8 is equal to a plus 3d. For the sixth term, we will have 14 is equal to a plus 6 minus 1d. Therefore, 14 is equal to a plus 5t. Now, we'll solve equation 1 and equation 2 simultaneously to get the value of a and d. Let's do that. A plus 5d is equal to 14. A plus 3d is equal to 8. Minus, minus, minus. 5d minus 3d, that's 2d, is equal to 14 minus 8, which is 6. Therefore, d is 3. So, you get the common difference. Now, we'll put the value of d in one of the equations and get the value of a. Let's do that. A plus 5 into 3 is equal to 14. Therefore, a plus 15 is equal to 14. Therefore, a is equal to minus 1, the first term. So, we get the first term and the common difference. Now, we have to find the sum of the first 20 terms. So, I hope you know the formula of sum. Sn is equal to n plus 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So, we will find the sum of first 20 terms. So, we get 20 by 2 plus into 2a, which is 2 into minus 1 plus n minus 1, which is 20 minus 1 into d, which is 3. So, what do we get? 20 by 2, that's 10 into minus 2 plus 19 into 3. So, we get 10 into minus 2 plus 57. So, we get 10 into 55, which is equal to 550, your answer. Okay. We move on to question number 3a. You have to simplify the given matrices. Let's do that. So, these matrices were given and we have to simplify them. So, let's do it. First, let's multiply them. So, what do we get? Sin a into sin a, that's sin square a minus sin a cos a. Sin a cos a and again sin square a. Over here, we get cos square a sin a cos a minus sin a cos a and cos squared a. So let's add them both. What do we get? Sin square a plus cos square a minus sin a cos a plus sin a cos a, which is 0. Sin a cos a minus sin a cos a, which is 0. And again sin square a plus cos squared a. So what do we get? We know the value of sin square a plus cos square a. It is 1. So we get 1, 0, 0, 1, which is also equal to I, 2. So this was a very easy question. Moving on. Moving on to B, a question from section formula. M and N are two points on the x axis and y axis respectively. P32 divides the line segment MN in the ratio 2:3. You have to find number 1 the coordinates of M and N and number 2 slope of the line MN. Let's do it. For the given question, the figure will look something like this. I have made this for your convenience. Over here, P is XY. This is X1, Y1. This is X2, Y2. 2 is equal to M and 3 is equal to N. I hope you guys know the sectional formula, which is X is equal to MX2 plus NX1 divided by M plus N and Y is equal to MY2 plus NY1. Divided by m plus n. Okay, using this we can find the value of small a and small b. So x over here is equal to 3, m is 2, x2 is 0, n is 3, x1 is a divided by m plus n, 2 plus 3, which is 5. Therefore, 3 5s are 15 by 3 is equal to a. Therefore, a is equal to 5. Similarly, over here we get y is 2, m is 2 into y2 is b plus n, which is 3, y1 is 0 divided by m plus n, which is 5. So 5 2s are 10 divided by 2 is equal to b. Therefore b is equal to 5. So we get the coordinates of m and n. What are those? M will be a0, that means 50, and n will be 05. Okay, now we have to also calculate the slope of the line. I hope you know the formula of slope, which is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So we have x1 y1 and x2 y2. So we get 5 minus 0 divided by 0 minus 5, which is 5 divided by minus 5, which is minus 1. So the slope of this line is minus 1. We move on to C, which is a question from mensuration. We have A solid metallic sphere of radius 6 cm is melted and made into a solid cylinder of height 32 cm. You have to find number 1 radius of the cylinder and number 2 curved surface area of the cylinder. You have to take the value of pi is equal to 3.1. Let's do this. So the radius of the metallic sphere was given, which is 6 cm, and the height of the solid cylinder was given 32 cm. Now the sphere was melted. So first let's calculate the volume of the sphere. Volume of sphere is 4 by 3 pi r cube. So 4 by 3 into 3.1, because it was given in the question that we have to take pi is 3 by 1. The radius is 6 into 6 into 6. So this comes out to be 892.8 centimeter cube. Now the cylinder was made using this volume. So the volume of the cylinder will be same. So let's calculate the volume of the cylinder. Volume of cylinder. This will also be equal to 892.8 centimeter cube. Using this, we can find the radius of the cylinder. So 892.8 is equal to pi r square h, the formula for volume of a cylinder. Therefore 892.8 is equal to pi, which is 3.1, into r square, that we have to calculate, into h, the radius, which is given 32. Therefore r square is equal to 892.8 divided by 3.1 into 32, which comes out to be 9. Therefore radius is equal to 3 centimeter. We cannot take minus because it is distance. So we know the radius now. This is your first answer. We also have to calculate the curved surface area. Number 2, CSA. I hope you know the formula of curved surface area, which is 2 pi r h. We have 2 into 3.1 into r, which is 3, into h, which is 32. So this comes out to be 595.2 centimeter square, the second answer. Moving on to 4, part A, a question from proportion. The following numbers k plus 3, k plus 2, 3k minus 7 and 2k minus 3 are in proportion. You have to find the value of k. Let's do this easy sum. We have the 4 numbers given which are in proportion. We have to find the value of k. Let's do this. It's very easy. They are in proportion. It means that k plus 3 is to k plus 2 is proportional to 3k minus 7 is to 2k minus 3. That means k plus 3 divided by k plus 2 is equal to 3k minus 7 divided by 2k minus 3. We'll cross multiply it. What do we get? K plus 3 into 2k minus 3 is equal to k plus 2 into 3k minus 7. Therefore 2k square minus 3k plus 3 2s are 6k minus 9 is equal to 3k square minus 7k plus 3 2s are 6k minus 14. So 6k and 6k gets cancelled out. We take all the things over here. What do we get? 3k square minus 2k square minus 7k plus 3k minus 14 plus 9 is equal to 0. So what do we get? K square minus 4k minus 5 is equal to 0. We'll use middle term factor. 5 into 1 is equal to 5. So what do we get? Minus 5 minus 1k minus 5 is equal to 0. Therefore k square minus 5k plus k minus 5 is equal to 0. Therefore k minus 5 plus 1 k minus 5 is equal to 0. Therefore k minus 5 into k plus 1 is equal to 0. So we get the values of k as 5 and minus 1. Okay, now we'll move on to the next question. Moving on to sum number B, we have solve for x the quadratic equation x square minus 4x minus 8 equal to 0. You have to give your answer correct to 3 significant figures. This is a very easy question. We will solve this using Sridhar Acharya formula. So this is the given quadratic equation. Let's write the values of a, b and c. Over here a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 4 and c is equal to minus 8. I hope you know Sridhar Acharya formula. X is equal to minus b plus minus root over b square minus 4ac divided by 2 into a. Let's put the values and we will get the value of x. So x is equal to minus of minus 4 plus minus b square minus 4 square, that's 16, minus 4 into a, that's 1, into minus 8, divided by 2 into 1, that's 2. So what do we get? Plus 4 plus minus root over 16 plus 8 4s are 32, divided by 2, this is equal to 4 plus minus root over 48 divided by 2. Now 48 is 16 into 3. So we can write that 16 into 3 divided by 2. So 4 plus minus, now we can take out this root 16. So we will get 4 outside, 4 root 3 divided by 2. So we ultimately get 2 plus minus 2 root 3. Now over here we will take the value of root 3 as 1.73. You should remember this value. So what do we get? 2 plus minus 2 into 1.73. So this is equal to 2 plus minus 2 into 1.73. Okay, I wrote this step again. So 2 plus minus 3.46. So x is equal to this. One value of x will be equal to 2 plus 3.46. And another value of x will be equal to 2 minus 3.46. So over here x is equal to 5.46. And over here x is equal to minus 1.46. Now remember, it was told in the question that you have to find it for three significant figures. So we have three significant figures over here and three significant figures over here. Now we move on to the next question. Moving on to C. Now this is after a long time that a construction question has come in section A. You have to use a ruler and compass only for answering this question. You have to draw a circle of radius 4 cm, mark the center as O, mark a point P outside the circle at a distance of 7 cm from the center. You have to construct two tangents to the circle from the external point P. You have to measure and write down the length of any one tangent. Let's do this. So guys, since it will take a lot of time to do the construction, we have taken a similar construction from a previous video where we have explained the construction of tangents. The link to that will be in the top right corner over here somewhere. Do check that out and you will have a better understanding. So guys, with the end of section A over here, we end this video. Section B will be uploaded very soon, so stay tuned. Until then, this is EduCeption signing off.